Welcome back, mi gente. I'm your host, Aida Yoguely. Today, you're gonna find out whether distilled water is the best purified water to make at home. This is the next part to my complete guide to healthy drinking water. So if you're debating whether to invest in a distiller, you definitely need to see this. I'll show you whether its effectiveness and convenience is worth the cost. Let's do this. Distilled water is a form of purified water that can be quite expensive and inefficient to obtain through bottled water. So let's look into what it takes to make distilled water at home using your tap water. The process of distillation consists of boiling water, such as water from your tap, to leave behind all the dissolved solids. Then immediately condensing all the vaporized water into a separate clean container in the form of liquid water. Point often overlooked, impurities can have a boiling point at or below that of water. If that's the case, then the impurity is transferred as vapor as well. This fact will be very important later. Hold on to it. You can make your own distilled water on the stove, or purchase an in-home distillation system. No matter which process you select, you'll have to deal with two annoying steps. The first is manually filling up the boiling chamber with tap water. And the second is waiting about 6 hours to make a single gallon of distilled water. Since the water will boil through the application of heat, the distillation system will need electricity to function. Imagine the scenario where you need to boil a gallon or more of water every day. That's gonna yield a very high energy bill. The next thing you absolutely need to factor in is maintenance. It's the one thing I always watch out for, because I wanna invest in buy it for life items. And the last thing you want is a product so complicated, you end up putting it away in the corner. Maintenance can make or break my decisions. As an engineer, what I'd like to know is how much time and money will it take me to maintain one of these? To figure this out, let's think through the distillation process. First item to account for is that there's a huge category of contaminants that have a tendency to vaporize at low temperatures due to their low boiling point. We call them volatile organic contaminants, or VOCs for short. There are volatile organic contaminants in the water. As I mentioned earlier in the process of distillation, any pollutant in the water that has passed their boiling point and is in the form of vapor ends up being transferred in the final product water. Remember how I mentioned earlier in the blog that in the US water treatment plants add chlorine to disinfect water? Well, the reaction of chlorine with organic matter in the water creates many unwanted VOC byproducts. A very large VOC category are total trihalomethanes, abbreviated THMs, which have been proven to be carcinogenic. In distillation, certain poisonous pesticides will also vaporize with the boiled water. Leave these contaminants in the water and you'll notice a foul taste and smell from the gases. And of course, they pose a health risk. So you'll need another process before condensation occurs to get rid of these VOCs. Which leads us into the fact that distillation systems need activated carbon filter replacements. The EPA states that one of the best available technologies to remove VOCs and the process that appears to have the most impact on pesticide removal is granular activated carbon, GAC. Activated carbon filters fluids by trapping the pollutants inside the pore structure of each granule of carbon. This is the process of adsorption. Distillation systems passes the water through an activated carbon filter. The purpose is to reduce these contaminants and consequently improve the taste and smell of the water. A distillation system plus an activated carbon filter makes one of the best purified waters you can drink. Once the contaminants saturate the carbon filter, it can no longer absorb pollutants and stops being effective. When a chemical comes in with a greater attraction force to the pore structure, it gets absorbed. In exchange, the activated carbon releases the weaker chemical. Typically, the activated carbon filter needs to be replaced every 1 to 2 months, and they cost about $4 per filter. In the worst case scenario, replacements equate to roughly $50 per year. Next, before you run off and get one of these, take into account that you need to manually scrub and flush away those limescale and pollutants every time you distill water. Scale is typically not easy to remove with just water. For this reason, you may need to let it soak in vinegar for an hour before being able to rinse it out. You can count the water used for cleaning as waste. Hence, technically, distillation is not a zero discharge, zero waste process. I use a little over a gallon of water each day, and I don't like the idea of finding time to clean this every day. Essentially becoming tied to the product. Although comparatively, it is still overall cheaper to have a home distillation system. That is, compared to going through all the trouble of purchasing and transporting already made distilled water from the grocery store. For these reasons, I decided not to go with a water distillation system. Next, I'm gonna show you a very attractive solution that yields purified water that is called reverse osmosis. Be sure to subscribe and hit the bell to stay tuned for the latest videos. Now I'd love to hear from you. Have you ever tried using a distillation system? How do you like it? If you have any questions, leave them in the comments below or join the discussion over at the Yoguely community forum. I'm Ida Yoguely. Thanks for learning with me today, and I'll see you in the next post. That's all, folks. If you'd like to help support more frequent, in-depth research videos that can help you in your daily life, head over to patreon.com/yoguely. Thanks. Gracias. Ciao, ciao.